Hi, I'm Jeff Sinley at the U.S. Geological Survey. I'm going to be talking about positional accuracy of the National Hydrography Dataset. This is a study that was done by myself and Kevin Roth, also of the U.S. Geological Survey. Our objective is to talk about positional accuracy of the NHD. And one of the problems in analyzing positional accuracy of hydrography is that there are no well-defined points. And so it's difficult to find a well-defined point in the landscape and measure its position against another well-defined point as a control point. So what we do is we analyze a stretch of river and measure the offsets. In this image, you can see that there's a river running down to the image, and there's those little yellow lines that are offsets. We measure these offsets at 100-foot intervals and measure a 1,000-foot or 5,000-foot stretch of the river. Then we measure the offsets and collect statistics. And by collecting many offsets, we are able to cancel out some of the errors and come up with statistics that are meaningful on positional accuracy. The first thing we're going to look at is the middle fork of the Platte River headwaters in Colorado. This is high in the mountains, about an elevation of 11,000 feet. We're looking at a stream that is probably about 1 cubic foot per second or less, high in the mountains in a broad valley. In 100 samples that we measured here, we have a mean of 27 feet of lateral offset error, a standard deviation of 20 feet, and a 90th percentile of 53 feet, meaning that 90% of our measurements are within 53 feet. So what we're doing is comparing the stream in the NHD, which is the blue line, to the stream that we see on the imagery. Also, of those 100 measurements, the maximum measurement was 92 feet. Further downstream, we're looking at the river in a broad U-shaped glacial valley. The stream has picked up a little bit more water at this point. Another 100 samples measuring at a mean of 25 feet, standard deviation of 26 feet, a 90th percentile of 45 feet, and a maximum deviation measurement of 70 feet. Here we're further downstream. Now the stream has become a double line stream, meaning the stream is more than 50 feet wide. And we're comparing the center line of that 50-foot-wide NHD stream to the stream in the imagery. Every 100 feet, we're measuring a lateral offset between the two. And here in 100 samples, we have a mean of 20 feet, a standard deviation of 14 feet, a 90th percentile of 39 feet, and a maximum deviation of 70 feet. Here the river is meandering quite a bit, and we find these maximum deviations where these large meanders are. And what we're seeing in the NHD is where streams are meandering in a floodplain, the meandering is changing quite a bit over the time that the NHD was originally compiled. And so this is very typical of the meandering changes that we find. Here we have a maximum of 70 feet offset, probably at one of those meanders. Here we're further downstream. Now the stream is probably running at about, say, 50 cubic feet per second. There's 100 samples. The mean is 24 feet. The standard deviation is 17 feet, 90th percentile is 45 feet, the maximum 104 feet. This is a broad floodplain. Here we're looking at the same stream running through a canyon. Here the stream is probably running on the order of 150 cubic feet per second. Samples 100, the mean is 15 feet, the standard deviation is 12 feet, the 90th percentile 31 feet, and the maximum 66 feet. You can see these statistics are quite a bit tighter, because the river is being confined by a canyon of granite rock, and it's no longer meandering through a floodplain, but it is more or less defined by the canyon walls, and so the deviations are quite a bit tighter. Here we're even further downstream, maybe looking at 200 cubic feet per second, and 100 samples, a mean of 20 feet, a standard deviation of 20 feet, a 90th percentile of 50 feet, and a maximum deviation of 91 feet. So you notice that in these past several measurements that we've looked at this river here, the means are pretty consistently around 20-25 feet. The standard deviations around 20-25 feet, meaning a rather tight distribution of the lateral offsets. 90th percentile of 50 feet, which is pretty consistent, and a maximum of 91 feet. So these numbers are more or less the numbers we're going to see across the nation. So let's look at some other statistics here. This is the frequency distribution of those measurements that we made. 500 measure points on the South Platte River. We can see the distribution mainly bunching up between 10 and 25 feet. Then the outliers, maximum displacement of 105 feet. Very few outlying measurements there. mostly bunched up around 10 to 30 feet or so. So this is also a very common frequency distribution that we'll find across the nation. It is an indication of what we will see. So our hypothesis is that this is what a frequency distribution will look like for the lateral offsets on a stream or a small river in the United States. Here's looking at Black Earth Creek in Wisconsin, just west of Madison. This is very typical of a meandering stream. Notice that the NHD, the light blue line, and the contemporary imagery, which shows that the stream has moved quite a bit in the last 30 years or so. Let's look at some statistics here. Here's 100 measurements. You can see the little yellow lines that are the lateral offsets that we're measuring the NHD stream against the stream in the imagery. 100 samples, a mean of 18 feet, standard deviation 11 feet, 90th percentile 34 feet, maximum of 61 feet. Further downstream, another 100 samples, 24 feet mean, a 15-foot standard deviation, a 44-foot in the 90th percentile, and a maximum of 86 feet. Let's look further downstream, another 100 samples, a mean of 26 feet, a standard deviation of 23 feet, a 90th percentile of 48 feet, a maximum of 130 feet. If you look at this closely, a good example once again of a stream. This is a single line stream. You can see how it matches up against the imagery and how the meanders are changing. So look at the frequency distribution. 300 samples, a mean of 23 feet in those samples. Standard deviation of 17 feet, a 90th percentile of 44 feet, maximum of 130 feet. So once again, these numbers in this frequency distribution seems to be pretty consistent around the country as you look at more and more data. Here are the frequency distribution between 10 and 30 feet or so, and a few outliers up to 130 feet, but very few. So this is what we think is going to be pretty consistent across the country.